teacher, humanitarian, and the founder of the American Red Cross, Clara Barton is one of the most honored women in American history. She was born on Christmas Day, 1821, in Oxford, Massachusetts.
At a very young age, she had to nurse her older brother who was quite sick, and very likely that led to her embracing the nursing skills and learning the skills that she used later on in the Civil War.
Clara Barton started off as a teacher and opened the nation's first free public school in 1854, before moving to Washington, D.C. to work for the U.S. Patent Office a year later.
Barton was, if not the first, one of the first women to work for the U.S. government in any capacity.
During the Civil War, Barton started aiding the wounded Union soldiers flooding into the Capitol. Soon she changed her focus to the front lines.
She saw that there was a need at the front for supplies, and she spent her own funds to bring them.
Barton earned the nickname Angel of the Battlefield when she showed up after midnight at the Battle of Cedar Mountain with a wagon load of supplies for the surgeons, and they had long since run out of things earlier in the day. She did that time and time again at small battles and very big battles, including the very bloody Battle of Antietam.
There's a story that at Antietam, she was so close to the battlefield that a bullet actually pierced through the sleeve of her dress.
After the Civil War, Barton traveled to Europe on her doctor's orders to rest. This didn't last long. While there, she met members of the International Red Cross and joined their volunteers on the battlefield of the Franco-Prussian War.
Barton returned to the United States shortly thereafter, and she brought this idea home with her. She felt that America needed a similar organization, and so she began the organization in 1881.
After founding the American Red Cross and becoming its head, Barton successfully lobbied to have the United States sign the Geneva Convention, the governing document behind all Red Cross societies. This basically made the American Red Cross legit.
In 1884, Barton saw to it that the American Amendment was added to the Geneva Convention. That amendment widened the work of Red Cross societies around the world to include not only the battlefield disaster work, but disaster relief in general.
Devoting her life to her work helping others, Clara Barton never married. At age 83, Barton retired from running the American Red Cross.
Clara Barton continued to pursue her humanitarian interests. She worked for women's suffrage, she worked with religious minorities, and she worked in prison reform.
Clara Barton built the American Red Cross from the ground up. She made that organization into what it is today, about 30,000 paid employees, over 500,000 volunteers, 500 chapters touching each and every community in this country. So that when we do something like respond to a large disaster, we embody that great humanitarian spirit that she had. That's her legacy.